by the zoo. It's not a zoo. And you can sometimes get it by the zoo. We have Baltimore iPads with year 7 and 8. And we're growing out iPads every year with year 7. So eventually we have a school for iPads. And that's people thinking, I'm doing that. Well, parents donate. You donate for the E-Learning Foundation. Pupil premium students, you know, it's got funding for them, so that's okay. But also some students are locked out and they still get use of iPads. So it's been very successful. A year and a half in. And we've been looking at, just to go back, at Shomi particularly, you've probably heard about Shomi, but it's a way of them giving you their work so you can market and then give them feedback and then send it back to them and then they can give it back to you. Improve. So usually, and I'm talking about secondary school here, to get feedback and for students to be able to respond to it, it's next lesson. Usually show me, you know, you can cut that time down. Next lesson could be 2 days, a week, 2 weeks in the secondary school. What we can do is that then, using show me. I'm going to just flip through some of these things, but we looked at our school because we looked at why we need to give feedback, and these are all the, sorry to mention the other way, the offset, reasons. We looked at that, and I'm going to flip through that, you know, scrutiny of work and so on, and why we should do it. And then we looked at the offset report, and Thursday reports actually said that, you know, the recommendations for lots and lots of schools from outstanding to special measures had marking as a recommendation. Okay. So 23 had marking related areas for improvement. So something that we needed to look at. You're also at the Education Endowment Foundation, so they said that essentially the most effective interventions are feedback. And that's competition, as you know, there is the way there's a lot of people touch with that. I'm just going to flip through, you know what feedback is, telling you what to do, how to improve, how to get to the next step, those goals and those targets. With that kind of feedback, that turns out students learn, and that's what we really need to focus on. Getting into act on it, not to read it, do nothing about it. So, you might have to show your high school third time and dedicated to improving reflection time. So, we make a point of when we give the feedback, actually giving them the time to do it. So, in secondary schools, I'm sure you know, it might happen in primary school, you might not get that time, so we made that part of our lesson planning. So we give them the time to respond to it. It might be in a lesson, it might be at home. But you need to teach the students how to do it. Otherwise, you know, you flounder. So it's very important that we do that. And we did that. And we also looked at keeping in careful kind of progress. So when they responded to the feedback that they were given, and write that feedback in there. It's very clear that you've acted on it, and then you can see that progress being made. And so, as I say, the training. We also look at TAF, which is a simple process, you know, giving them a target based on what they've done, you know, and then students act on that target, so that's the action. And then we comment on the progress, what progress has been made since that action was taken. And that's simplified for a lot of staff. And of course, most effective feedback is there, because it's immediate and it's specific. Or can feedback be more immediate? So these are examples of showing where students have either uploaded where that they've done, or there's a dialogue going on between the teacher and the students, It's a secure app, it's a free app. And students get invited to a class by the teacher. So it's monitored, you know exactly who's responding and who's saying what. And if you've done it every time, so I can, you know, sit and watch your favourite TV programme and not on through my show. And here's some more, this is in art. So if you can upload photographs as well and art there, and then you can send it back to them and say, you know, how can this be improved? And here's some English as well, where there's a dialogue between the teacher and the students about what we've read and you know, how we can improve. So. And there's ways of annotating, so these are yellow circles and ways of putting notes onto it. So you're not actually writing over it, you can improve it there. And then some feedback on John. Geography using what went well, even better if. As a way of and so there's, you know, the point I'm trying to make with that is the students need to be trained and the staff need to follow these procedures and they need to be sure to check on and make that progress between levels. We also use Socrative, and though we get Socrative, it's a quiz type app which is really, really useful in the classroom, you get immediate feedback as well. We've got the system all there, and I'll be able to finish. If you're interested, you can come to my school, we call it a regional training centre for Apple. Not that we sell out of problems, but we train teachers on using iPads. There was a literacy training in last night, and it was mainly primary school staff to teachers. The next one is the 26th of February, and that